On Hatteberg's People, sometimes people make history, sometimes people teach it. In Abilene, there is the Seelye Mansion, and for years, Dorothy Snider has been a tour guide for this little piece of history, and few are more knowledgeable or enthusiastic about their work. She works here in this mansion that occupies a block of Abilene's Main Street.
The Seelye Mansion has 25 rooms, and to me, it is arranged just for common living so that anybody could live here and enjoy it.
The mansion was built in 1905 at a cost of $55,000. The Seelye's daughters, Helen and Marion, were just girls when it was built. They never married and lived in the home into their 90s until they passed away. Now the mansion is open to tourists, and Dorothy Snider makes that history come alive.
These three buttons were in the parents' bedroom, and they would summons whichever maid they wanted, and the buttons are pearl buttons to summons maids.
The family's money came from the sister's father, who made his fortune in patent medicine, founding the A.B. Seelye Medical Company. Some of that medicine still on display at the mansion.
I've lived a good many years and used some of these products, so it takes you back to the good old days.
The Seelye family lived in luxury for the time. Many of their furnishings purchased at the 1904 World's Fair, like this fireplace.
Well, it was designed by Tiffany at the World's Fair, and the tile is from Venice, Italy. Italy had the very best tile. Any dresser that's extremely low is called a gentleman's dresser. It gives the appearance of a full-length mirror. Father and mother wanted their daughters to have something very special at the St. Louis World's Fair in 1904, and they bought each of them a set of silver mirror and brush. This one has Helen's name on it, and the adjoining room, Marion has her set.
There are 11 bedrooms, a ballroom, servants' quarters, and a myriad of bathrooms within the 11,000 square feet of living space. But one of the more unusual items is this. A bowling alley. Again purchased at the 1904 World's Fair. Upstairs, book collections that any book lover would salivate over.
One of my tourists asked me to lift the lid to the Mark Twain books, and a couple of years ago, for the very first time, I discovered the authorized unified edition of my books, Mark Twain. Now, can you put a price on a set of books with a signature like that?
Dorothy is full of information and anecdotes about the family, and this mansion is just as the sisters left it. Their dolls on the dressers, the wash basins, and the pitchers waiting as if for the Seeleys to return.
Oh, I can give the tour four times a day, and I never tire of it. The beauty of the antiques and the well-kept house makes it enjoyable.
Now, Dorothy knows all the history, and people remember her. The red shoes on the blouse, and the name Dorothy.
And then they always bid me, goodbye, Dorothy. Dorothy, goodbye.